Christian has asked, what are the large differences between building a naturally aspirated block and a forced induction block? I wouldn't say there's a lot of differences, really. One of the biggest considerations would come down to be the compression ratio of the engine. With a naturally aspirated engine, obviously we're going to be more often than not shooting for a higher compression ratio than in forced induction, so that's one consideration. Some of our clearances will be different, though, particularly our piston to cylinder wall clearance. We can generally run tighter piston to cylinder wall clearances on a naturally aspirated engine simply because we're not putting as much heat into the crown of the piston, so the piston is not going to expand as much as it will in a forced induction application. And then we also need to consider the strength of the components, because again, a forced induction engine is going to be working harder. It's going to be producing more torque, more cylinder pressure, so it's more likely that we're going to need better components in order to ensure reliability. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.